Hey, we want to thank y'all for coming out. We've got a little bit of a cold, so we can't do a show. Thanks.
Cool.
You guys look like you're too old for children's music, anyway.
John's accordion is stuck a little bit, so I'll make some stage announcements. It's very exciting to see all so many people here in one place. We regret that we didn't charge for this event. If you are totally oriented towards the free, we want to remind you that John and I will be celebrating our 20th anniversary as a band at a free show in Central Park on August 15th. It's a Thursday night. It's a nighttime show. It's totally free. And please feel free to come down. It's it's part of Summer Stage in New York City. And I'm quickly running out of things to say. I think you should show people what's wrong and explain what's going to happen so they understand this isn't just some way to get people to buy more CDs at the CD stand.
There's a button that's, although that's not a bad suggestion, there's a button that's stuck on the back of the accordion and plays the E diminished chord, which doesn't work with all our material.
Right. It wouldn't normally really come up at all, except that if he doesn't fix it, it'll be playing through every song. It all started in the small town of Lincoln, Massachusetts, ladies and gentlemen. Two angry, embittered young men got together and decided to waste their entire adult lives. So,
that's gigantic!
Oh, which reminds me of the other thing I forgot to plug. In Boston, at the Museum of Fine Arts, all through August and September, they're going to be showing this documentary about They Might Be Giants called Gigantic. There's going to be 10 performances each month. I'm not sure when, but my parents are very proud of that gig. Which reminds me...
I'm making progress here, John.
He's making progress. We want to remind everybody in the crowd, if you could turn on your cell phones or pagers for the entire show, there's nothing more exciting than phones ringing in the middle of a very quiet song.
Yeah, you want to call
you
it?
Really don't mind at all.
I guess. Cool.
You need a screwdriver or something?
Yeah, I can go get something for you.
What's that?
Can you hold this?
Just, let it run or whatever.
Yeah. A Swiss Army knife or something?
I have my beret for my hair.
This honestly happens to us all the time, so don't think it's freaking us out.
That's done it. Thanks a lot. Appreciate it.
Yay!
Jared!
So
The guy with the shirt with the picture of Gary Coleman on it. It says bling bling.
Give me a little
thing like.
His accordion.
Somehow
broken.
Got through the security.
So, yeah, someone broke his accordion. They just fixed it, though, okay. So they're gonna start, so I better get on. I'll just put it down.
In a future time, children will work together to build a giant cyborg. Robot parade, robot parade, wave the flag that the robots made. Robot parade, robot parade, robots obey what the children say. Electric trains, here comes a robot with electric brains. Robot parade, robot parade, wave the flag that the robots made. Robot parade, robot parade, robots obey what the children say.
The no record is in general is not a record that will inform kids very much of stuff. It's not really that kind of. It's not really like a Schoolhouse Rock, Free to Be You and Me type of, you know, remedial, you know, make the kids better, punish them in some way. Kind of. But we do have a couple songs in our repertoire that do tell you about stuff. This one is not on the children's record. And it does tell you about stuff. It's mostly factual.
See if you can figure out which part is actually not factual.
Incandescent gas, a gigantic nuclear furnace where hydrogen is built into helium at a temperature of millions of degrees. Yo-ho, it's hot. The sun is not a place where we could live. But here on Earth there'd be no life without the light it gives. We need its light. We need its energy. Without the sun, without a doubt, there'd be no you and me. The sun is a mass of incandescent gas, a gigantic nuclear furnace where hydrogen is built into helium at a temperature of millions of degrees.
The sun is so hot that everything on it is a gas. Copper, aluminum, everything a gas.
The sun is large.
The sun is so large a million Earths could fit inside, and yet the sun is just a middle-sized star.
The sun is far away.
The sun is about 93 million miles away, and that's why it looks so small.
But even when it's out of sight, it shines both night and day. The sun gives light, the sun gives heat, the sunlight light that we see. The sunlight comes from our own sun's atomic energy.
There's more. Scientists have found that the sun is a huge atom-smashing machine. The heat and light from the sun are caused by the nuclear reaction between estrogen, and more estrogen.
The sun is a massive incandescent gas, a gigantic nuclear furnace, where hydrogen is built into helium at a temperature of millions of degrees.
Can everybody hear everything?
Is this PA awesome or what? This is our very own PA. It's been held in a mold chamber for 2 years, and it still works perfectly. Here's a brand new song off our brand new album. We want to remind everyone who doesn't have children in the audience that someday you might. And just in preparation, you know, Rounder's been in business for a long time, but we've seen other record companies on the skids recently. And it might not be available in that future time when you have children. So you might want to pick up 2 copies, one for you and one for your children.
Right.
In the future.
And get some little baby gap shoes while you're at it.
It's best to be prepared.
Get stuff now.
Yeah, get it now. Get it now. Don't make the same mistake that so many other parents have made before they had children. Be prepared. Here's a song from No.
This is from No. It's from No.
Violin, limb, limb. Violin, limb, limb. Violin, limb, limb. Oh, violin, limb, limb. Violin, limb, limb. Violin, limb, limb. Hippo, 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 hippo. Speck of dust, 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 speck of dust, 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 speck of dust, dust, dust. Speck of dust, 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 speck of dust, 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 speck of dust, dust, dust. George Washington's head, half of George Washington's head, 3/4 of George Washington's head, all of George Washington's head.
Thank you.
I'll just stumble to Constantinople, been a long time gone. Constantinople, now a journey shall lie. I'm moving at every gal of Constantinople. There's a disciple of Constantinople, so if you would take from Constantinople, she'll be waiting in Istanbul. Even though New York was once through Amsterdam, why they changed it, I can't say.
You'll just liked it better that way.
So take me back to Constantinople. No, you can't go back to Constantinople. Been a long time gone. Constantinople, why they're not standing over that it works. That's nobody but the Turks. Istanbul. Why they changed it, I can't say.
Builders liked it better that way.
So take me back to Constantinople.
No, you can't go back to Constantinople. Been a long time gone. Constantinople, why did Constantinople get the worst? That's nobody's business but to them.
A true story about that song. We were doing this like miserable showcase gig in 1988 at this place called, what was the place? It was like a Mexican restaurant in London, which is a bad idea in the first place. But we were doing it was 12:30 in the afternoon, and the whole plan was to get us a publishing deal. And this guy who was, I think he was actually 1,000 years old, who was working for Chapel Music, which is a venerable 1,000-year-old music publishing company in London, heard us, and we played, you know, three songs, and that song, which is we didn't write, swept him away so much that he gave us a publishing deal, and I never really had the heart to tell the guy that we didn't write the song.
Right.
You know, it's like,
you're gonna make a lot of money with that song. Right. We're gonna get rich together.
That song was probably already on Chapel.
Yeah. Probably signed it for writers 20 years earlier.
You keep signing that song over and over.
But here's another song we played in that miserable restaurant from that wonderful time.
The shoehorn, the kind with teeth. For state and their police, he wants a shoehorn, the kind with teeth. Cause he knows there's no such thing. He asks the girl if they can both sit in a chair, but he doesn't get nervous. She's not really there. He wants a shoehorn, the kind with teeth. Cause he knows there's no such thing. Tour the world in a heavy metal band, but they run out of gas. The plane can never land. He wants a shoehorn, but I will be. He tried to feel a note for stating their beliefs. He wants a shoehorn, but I will be. Cause he knows there's no such thing. What's the sense in ever thinking about the tune when you're much too busy returning to the room? He wants a shoehorn, the kind with teeth. People say for stating their beliefs. He wants a shoehorn, the kind with teeth. Cause he knows there's no such thing.
Well, that's, you know, that's kind of a grown-up song.
But we thought the kids might understand.
I think older brothers get that song.
Yeah, absolutely.
So here's a brand new song.
Returning to the womb part, I think. Yeah. Speaks to everyone.
Here's a brand new song. We want to remind everybody that DepecheMode.com is available at any time. Check it out. It's crazy. Here we go. The song's called 402. It's based on a real life event that happened to John Lennon.
Right.
Not me.
About a clock. The song tells really stories.
1, 2, 3, boom.
underneath the big clock at the corner of 5th Avenue and 22nd Street. I stood and waited for a girl I knew at the spot where we'd agreed to meet. It was 4 minutes of two. At 4 of 2, I was waiting for the girl. I was 4 minutes early for a date with her. I was planning to say I was in love with her. And sooner than she stood for a door, I'm a date, and the clock said 4 of 2. At 4 of 2, I was staring into space. She was not yet late, according to the clock. I was feeling nervous, so I kept looking up at the clock. Something out of the side of the building, and it still said 4 of 2. At 4 of 2, I began to feel tired, and I rubbed my eyes, and again I checked the time. It seemed as if the sky was growing dark, but I felt reassured when I looked at the clock and it still said 4 of 2. I laid my head down on the sidewalk so in case she were coming I would have a better view. But nobody was there, so I stretched out and closed my eyes for a second or two. It was 4 minutes of two. At first I woke to a futuristic noise from flying cars and gigantic metal bars. I'd grown a beard and was long and white, but I knew that the girl would be coming very soon. For though everything had changed, it was still that clock, and it still said 4 of 2.
So super cool. We want to thank them for the coffee drink syrup, which we are going to take home to New York and enjoy at the earliest possible convenience.
We'll be pouring vinegar on our French fries later.
We got one more song for you now. It's also off of No. We want to remind everybody that we are going to be here after you're all gone. So feel free to come up to the autograph thing, and with whatever you've got, small pieces of crumpled paper are perfectly acceptable.
We're out of time.
I can't hear anything anymore. But we're going to be signing stuff. We're going to be anything. Grab a book you might want to purchase. We love signing books. We love signing anything. So we want to remind everybody also, if you're like a total cheapskate and you never want to buy anything ever again, we've got a perfect solution. Sign up on our email list and we will send you MP3s for the rest of your life. Say what?
You didn't play an encore?
No. Our encore is sitting at the table and signing stuff for like an hour and a half. Believe me, we're going to be here for a really long time. Like when the last people leave, it's going to be like,
well, you guys must be tired, dude.
So feel free to get stuff signed. We really want to encourage that. And do sign up for the email list because the MP3 thing, it's crazy. But it's really catching on. So here's a song.
This is also from our record. Our new record, the one we're promoting.
Here we go.
It has about a million other cool songs that we don't know how to play.
The day is done, the sun is down, the curtains have been drawn, and darkness has descended over everything we know. The covers have been turned and I put my pajamas on. I've had my fun, I've stretched and yawned, and all is said and done, I'm going to bed. There's nothing left to do. I ate three meals, I rode my bike, I hung out with my friends. I got the moon, I watched TV, I practiced the guitar. I brushed my teeth, I read my book, and then I sat around, I'm going to be. Directly out.
Thank you all for coming out. It's really exciting to see so many people here. It's really great. Thank you.